Welcome back to the Artie Lang Show. Talking with the great Trevor Price here.
Oh,
Fox
great
Sports
One. Look at that.
Crowd goes wild. You got to bear with me. We have a guy that calls all the time who does prank calls for us. Sometimes he gets Frances on FAN. It's the funniest thing. He tries to work in our show, to the lexicon of the American culture. Rod in Bayside. What's up, Rod?
What's going on? The Rod wildfire is spreading.
Oh, my God. I knew it was only going to be a matter of time before you named this and had some sort of hashtag. Is this Rod wildfire hashtag /goingcrazy.com?
It's trending on Twitter right now.
Yeah. All right. Well, who do you get? Describe this. Who do you get on this one?
Well, I got Steve Summers and Tony Page.
Steve Summers of the Schmooze.
Yeah, I was very upset about the Richie Incognito situation because I've had some past experiences, an event that I thought were worse than that.
So you called up about it?
Yeah, I called up and I talked to them about it.
All right, who do we have first? Summers, all right. Here's Rod pranking Steve Summers of WFAN.
Ronaldo is calling from Newark, New Jersey. And Ronaldo, you're on the fan of New York City, and thank you for the call.
Schmooze, how are you?
Okay, Ronaldo, what can you say?
Steve, I'm a huge fan of yours, and it's an honor to speak to you.
I'm sorry, one more time?
I said I'm a huge fan of yours, and it's an honor to speak to you.
I'm going to ask you to say it again. I can't. No, I'm just kidding. Well, thank you for that. I appreciate. Listen, if you're not, I appreciate you being there, right, for sure.
If heaven had green lights, they would be your eyes, Steve.
What is this?
I said if heaven had green lights, they would be your eyes.
That's right.
Now, this Incognito situation is truly a terrible thing, Steve. The only situation I could think of to compare it to is when Dan Filato tried to put his meat whistle on Shane Elrod's lunchbox.
Okay, see, when he's talking about green eyes and he's a fan, then you got to believe something's wrong. Because right away, the ears go up and the red light goes off. And right away, both Russell and myself had our finger on the dump button. And you knew right away something was up with him cutting himself off for the simple reason he's talking. He's a fan of mine. That alone would tell you something is wrong.
All right, wait. First of all, I gotta fess up here. I, like an idiot, I tell the truth all the time, and I admit it in a book in an interview that I wrote a poem to my fiance, and the line, "If you haven't had green lights," is in the poem. So that's why I deserve that too for that. And secondly, what is the accent you're doing? What is Ronaldo in Newark? What is that?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
Oh, God, that's hilarious.
I didn't hear the line exactly. When Dan Filato put his meat whistle, what?
And Shane Elrod's what?
I think it was, I forgot exactly what I said. It might have been Fudge Garage or...
Oh, God, worse, what?
Fudge Garage. Well, that's perfectly, which with the FCC were perfectly acceptable. Now, is that true, Dan? Did you ever put your meat whistle on Shane Fudge Garage?
But Trevor, we can loan ride to your show.
No, we're good.
I have man-on-man sex. So I would have man-on-man sex.
Chill out, man. I'm not right. Coming back.
I'm coming back. All right, so set up the next one.
Well, in the Tony Page one, I also comment on the Incognito situation and some bullying I saw in the past.
Okay, here we go. My God. So disrespectful.
Gustavo in Brooklyn. Gustavo, you're in the face.
Gustavo!
Hey, how are you?
I'm all right, man. How are you?
I'm good. Well, Tony, this Miami Dolphins situation, I got to say, it really hits home for me. Mm-hmm. I played some small-time college football, and I'm a witness to some of these terrible hazing instances. I mean, one time, and believe me, I'll never forget this, I open up one of the equipment room doors, and I see John Ritchie just donkey-punching Dan Filato.
Yeah, some people just wait all day to come on and waste everybody's time. No, it's not funny, and you got dumped, and nobody got to hear it. So, take another station.
First of all,
ball.
Tony, it's hilarious. that's great. And by the way, I didn't know that either. That is very disturbing.
Yes.
Must have
been a blackout.
Rod, can I ask you something? You start off every call with an accent, and you immediately abandon it. Like, you go, hello, how are you? Yeah, how you doing? Okay. what is that about? Like, as an actor, you have to have more confidence.
Well, you know what it is? Like, when I get on the phone with the call screener, I have, like, a completely different accent on. And then for some reason, when I'm on the call, my voice always reverts back to my regular voice.
You lose it. It gives you respect for Meryl Streep. That's hard to do throughout a movie.
You got to. Once you get into the role, you have to inhabit the role. You don't hear about the stories about Daniel Day-Lewis doesn't come out of character.
That's right.
Yeah. Until the DVD comes out. Yeah. You know what I mean? I am Abraham Lincoln. Yeah. No, you're not. You're Daniel Day-Lewis.
Right, inhabit Gustavo. Next time.
Gustavo. Gustavo. All right, well, good job, Rod. Listen, I can't officially tell you to keep this up, but keep this up. You got to hear some of the. Do we have any of his. I want Trevor to. Do we have any of his Francesas that we could play? Give me one second. You know who Mike Francesa is.
Yeah, of course.
He's been a nuisance to him. If Francesa ever saw me, he'd punch me in the face. Yeah, listen to a couple of these.
Steve in Manhasset. What's up, Steve?
Hey, Mike. I know how you feel about Artie Lang. What are your thoughts on Nick DiPaolo?
Don't have any. I'll be honest with you, don't have any. You know? That was supposed to be an Andy Pettit question turned into a comedian question, but hey, you know.
Is that the first
I'm
one
very
ever?
I'm very happy Andy's coming back.
It might be. Go ahead.
Give me another one.
Eric in Oceanside, what's up?
Eric in Oceanside.
Good, what's happening?
Who do you think will win that WrestleMania in a match? You versus Artie Lang.
I'll do that. That guy calls like all the time with that stuff. Neil in Fordham, what's up, Neil?
The best are his reactions afterwards because he ends up, he doesn't want to give it attention, but he talks for 2 minutes about it. Yeah. Go ahead.
Corey in Bayside, what's up, Corey?
Hey, Mike, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
Mike, I think the most important date for all Yankee fans right now is October 29th, 2013.
All right, want to tell me why?
That's when Artie Lang's book, Crash and Burn, comes out.
I knew it would be something.
Happy now. That's amazing. That is
like, you want to tell me why? he just had a perfect plug. Yeah, well, a couple more. They're real quick.
I can see that.
Yeah, they're, these are to the point.
Yeah, these are straight to it.
Yeah. You got those?
Give me, hit me tube sock.
Tube sock. that's a way better nickname for you. I like that.
You ever see that commercial?
No.
Hit me tube sock. Oh, dude. Old man.
Hit me tube sock.
I think you have to go listen yourself. Oh. Kevin in Flushing, what's up, Kevin?
Hey, Mike, you should get a sense of humor and come to Artie
Lang's
book signing.
Oh, God! Calls that gets beeped off every time. It's amazing. He calls to promote another show, folks, and he gets bounced off every time. It's unbelievable. JD and Montclair, what's up, JD?
Well, yeah, again, Mike, I have to tell you, I know you're not listening, but if someone who knows you, they're getting on the air, Mike.
Right. We're somebody has them.
We're listening to them. Mm. All right, well, let's start to some more NFL here. Because,
why?
We're gonna take a break. I got a lot of questions about the NFL right now because it's great. First of all, Peyton Manning status, and did he bite off more than he could chew physically? I don't know. I mean, I hope the guy's playing amazing football, but I don't know. It's starting to. Maybe he didn't have a whole season.
Put him in for the last 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Give him half the season off.
The other Carolina Panthers, a lot of stuff. I would take a break. We'll come back with Trevor Price. Welcome back to the Artie Lang Show, and I want to say thanks to French Quarters Guest Apartments for being our New York City hotel. Let them be your headquarters in New York City. Go to FrenchQuartersNY.com to book your next stay. FrenchQuartersNY.com to book your next stay. So, yeah, Peyton Manning.
What about him?
What's you think he's hurt, like to the point where he can't play? I'm hoping.
No.
He got that look on his face. Remember when Leonard Marshall hit Joe Montana in that one of those playoff games?
I'm going to pretend I'm that old to say yes.
Well, come on, you were a kid. You were there. Now your back is great. His back is like, can I play anymore? And he couldn't. Right. He's a Giant fan. I loved it. I don't know. Peyton Manning's got that same look on his face.
The funny thing is, he always looks like that. That's what I'm saying. He's always
Eli always looks like that.
But this most recent post game press conference with Peyton, he seemed much angrier and pissy than I've ever seen.
He didn't want to discuss it. He's like, look, man.
A part of that is the way he's wired because. like most of those alpha quarterbacks, he think the league is built around him, which in a way
it kind of is, but
the fact that it was a legal hit, I mean, don't get upset about it. It's football. You know what I mean? So,
you know, he was not trying to hurt you. I can understand how, you know, he's dealing with a high ankle and this just kind of exacerbates it. Yeah, it's awful.
Explain a high ankle.
You got two bones in your lower leg, your tibia and your fibula, and they're held together in place by something called the syndesmotic membrane.
Stamper.
Okay. Wow.
This is why Jonathan Martin got beat up in his locker room.
Shut up. I'm going to ass in your mouth.
You get hit.
You're talking like that. I'm gonna S in your mouth, pal. You keep it up, pal. I got you in my thoughts, boy. Asthmatic membrane, my ass.
Well, that syndesmotic membrane tears, and then those two bones in your lower leg, they just kind of do whatever they want, and there's no blood flow in that syndesmotic membrane, so it takes forever to heal. It's just complete instability. Yeah, that's right. what happened to him.
It stings now.
It's bad.
I will tell you. I will tell you a very personal story. Yeah. I've had one of these.
Right.
I did not get it playing football. I got it playing pickup soccer.
No.
On an indoor field.
How old
at
you?
Six?
Not during
30,
the season.
I was 33.
Right?
Oh, so you were in the league.
I was
so
in the league. Off season.
Did you keep that from
played,
your team?
Yes, I did. Yeah. I played indoor soccer to train. You know, as cardio.
Why would they let you do that?
They did not. They did not know about it. It was 6 o'clock in the morning. I was living in Denver. I was playing for Baltimore.
Because that's a lot of exercise.
Exercise is good for me, right? And I love the game, right? So I go to take a shot, and some yahoo sticks his foot out, and my foot hit his foot, and then hits the ground, and like I get a high ankle sprain. Mm. I limped for 3 weeks.
Wow.
That's bad.
And finally, like right before training camp, I healed and I showed up. They're like, "You're fat." I was like, "No, I'm strong." I was just fat and out of shape.
I used to
3 weeks of sitting on my butt.
Oh, man.
You know, blocking for Tyrone Wheatley at Michigan. But Tyrone Wheatley was a big guy. You know,
I know he is. Yeah, I'm a Giant fan. I know.
And there were a lot of times lead blocking for him where he would just, you know, destroy me, just blast me from behind.
Right.
If I didn't get good movement on my block, he was just gonna run me over from behind. So he gave me a high ankle sprain 1 year, and it was devastating. I mean, I was out for like a month. I was trying to come back, it just wouldn't heal. And then the very next season, exact same leg, he did it again.
Yeah.
I got another high ankle sprain from Tyrone. So I thanked him profusely for that.
Kicked him in his gonads.
How long does it take to get over that?
Well, it depends. The first time you do it, it's worse. The second one that I had, apparently when you tear that membrane the second time, it's not as traumatic, and you don't get as much displacement.
I was playing indoor pickup soccer, so I told nobody about this.
Right. Yeah.
So I had no idea.
So you have to keep that
membrane
under wraps. So you probably remember a month.
Painful.
I think a month.
Painful.
But I don't think you are. There's like stages of ability. Like for Peyton Manning, he doesn't have to move around much.
Right.
You know.
That's
so
true.
He can deal with this.
So you know what you do? Do you know what you do if you're Kansas City Chiefs? You send the house at them.
Yeah.
You send everybody.
Hey, look, it's ruthless, but that's
right.
Ruthless.
That's
see,
they don't have to.
The first thing I was told when I got to NFL by one of our older guys, said, listen, whatever's happening on one side of your body, you tape that thing up, tape it up on the other side.
Yeah. Right.
If you have a bad elbow, tape up both elbows.
Right,
bad wrist, tape up both wrists.
Because
they will find it.
Wow.
Right.
Now, listen, again, it's football. It's what it is, you know?
I don't think the Chiefs have to send the house. And I think
Peyton Manning,
he invites.
Why not?
He likes that, man. Like,
he does, but you keep hitting him enough. You keep hitting him enough. I've seen him going to a show now.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, if you show him enough deception and he doesn't know exactly what he's looking at,
that has only happened to him in my estimation one time, and that was with the team I was on with the Jets with Rex Ryan.
Yeah.
And Rex Ryan had him thoroughly confused.
Okay.
Now, wasn't that the
Saints did it in the Super Bowl
really?
When they lost that.
Yeah.
Thoroughly confused. He had no idea what coverage.
How do you do that, though?
I think, from what I was sitting in the meeting, not paying attention to the parts of the back end of the defense, just the front part.
Yeah.
And what seemed like was happening, we were playing a zone and man at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So you carry your man like it's a man, and whatever your man went to, or if your guy went this way, that became your zone. If your guy went this way, if your guy went up the field, you are not a safe
so man. You gotta be a good athlete.
You gotta be a good athlete to do that.
What do you call it?
I have no idea what they were calling
you
it.
You now become a safety.
It's like, okay, I had a tight end. The tight end runs a seven route down the field.
It's crazy.
You're now the deep safety.
Wow.
And you break him off and just stand there. And then Peyton Manning had no idea what
that's
was going
a great
on.
Idea. And I never paid attention to
if you got guys
either.
Who could execute that.
That's right. Right. Yeah, we did.
Well, that's the thing. Usually it's man or zone or a combination where you play man
on one side.
You can do man on one side, zone on the other, or you can play man underneath and then stick two safeties deep.
That's a football jargon, but just know that
it was something I haven't heard.
I kind of went, yeah, okay, that works, but yeah. I've never seen him not be able to figure it out. He had no clue.
The thing is, I think the Kansas City Chiefs defensive coordinator Bob Sutton is a really sharp guy, and
he came from under Rex Ryan.
Is
he there?
Yes, he was.
Well,
Sutton was there. Bob was there.
I think we'll probably see that again.
That's a fun game to watch. Right? This weekend, Broncos Chiefs.
He will have something that confuses Peyton Manning.
Well, that's a game of the week. We gotta take another break. We'll be back right after. Welcome back to the Ari Lang Show, and we just got a couple minutes here. Trevor Price is here from Fox Sports. Hey, what about Cam Newton now and the Carolina Panthers? Are they something that's for real?
Hey, listen, when you have a defense, when you have the two best inside linebackers in the NFL, or at least two of the top five guys in the NFL, and the other kid, the Davis kid that plays next to him, these two kids flat out play football, right? And then you have the physical front that they have. Yeah. And they have two pass rushers. They have Charles Davis and the other kid who was undrafted. I forget his name, number 76. When you have two pass rushers, two middle linebackers, and you have basically an offense, a quarterback that scares people, an offense that scares people, a quarterback that scares
people.
He's
a big guy. I played with him in that first beach ball I was in. He's our coach or whatever.
He's a big guy, but their offensive line
is impressive.
It is impressive.
Yeah.
So finally, you know what happens? Here's what happens, Artie. If you stink for a long time and you keep getting high draft picks, you will eventually turn the corner.
That's what happens. Yeah. Right?
That's what happens. That's what happens to the Chiefs.
Well,
that's
if one of your guys puts a hit out on his girlfriend, you know, you get.
Jesus Christ.
You start to, you know. Did you ever see that? 30 for 30. Whatever it is, there's some documentary about that. But the two guys he hired.
Yeah.
I never saw that.
You have to check it out.
No, you do not.
Steve Harvey. Harvey and the original Kings of Comedy, you know, they taped in Carolina. He's talking about Ray Caruth. Steve Harvey goes, I was watching on CNN. When they caught that car, I said, you are not in the trunk. You are not in the trunk. Oh, God. I go, when I've seen him in the trunk, I go, what? You ain't in the trunk? That's the first place. You are not in the trunk. But you have to. I'm plugging this now. I don't know where to find it. The two guys he hires are like Abbott and Costello look like two scientists. Like, what was he thinking was going to happen?
They're not from Stanford.
No, they're not.
So,
well, Trevor, listen, man, great to have you on always.
I appreciate it. I got nothing to do on a Tuesday night.
Well, come back, man.
I'll come back.
Come back whenever you like.
That's great, man.
Again, the show is Crowd Goes Wild. Fox Sports 1, and sorry
with,
about
with
the
Regis. Sorry Regis, about the Regis and, called me Prepper and yesterday. Yeah.
Did he really?
He called me Prepper. He called me Derek.
It's on weekdays at 5.
5 p.m.
And you're Amon Regis Hillman.
Yeah, Regis Hillman.
The Artie Lang
Show. Prepper, what do you think?
The Artie Lang Show. Weeknights on Audience. Only on DirecTV.